To God be the glory. To God be the glory. I tell you, if it wasn't for the Lord who was on my side, where would I be? And I know that I could pass this mic all around the room, and that would be all of our testimonies. If it had not been for the Lord, where would we be? The word of God says that we are more than conquerors. The word of God said that we are more than conquerors. We are fearfully and wonderfully made. Our hope is in him. And that's where I stand today. Without God by my side, I would not be in front of you today. I thank my friend for the introduction. I thank my classmate, Mia, for the invitation. And yes, we started off in Memorial Junior High School back in seventh grade. And it's been a journey. And I can say that I never thought that this was going to be part of my journey, but God. My sister that came before me said that God has a plan for us. And back in those days, I had another plan, and she was my neighbor. They're two doors down from me in Vineland on Cornell Street. And I became a mother at a very early age, and she actually watched my daughter and my kids while I could work and continue. So I truly thank God for her and seeing her today and all that God has done in your life. And you are an inspiration as well. Like I said, to God be the glory. I'm only up here to give some encouraging words, but there's a cliche or a phrase that everybody's saying today is, and that is, yesterday's price is not today's price. And so I stand here today, yesterday's April is not today's April. And if you say that for yourself, because some people won't allow you to move. Some people will always remember who you used to be. So, you know, when God spoke that, who am I? I had to take off who I wasn't. Because sometimes when people put who you are, and not only people, you put it on yourself. I had to look myself in the mirror and deal with all the April that I didn't like, that I did to myself. But I thank God that he allowed me grace and his mercy and his tender kindness toward me, allowed me to say today, yesterday's April is not today's April. And guess who prayed the highest price for us? That can't nobody pay. And that was God himself. He paid a price for us. So I thank God. All of us today, you know, we can, you see me up here. You know, we all look fashionable. We all got our hats on. We all look good. But no one knows your mind. He said, renew your mind. And I've been through some things. You know, not going all the way back, but God has brought me a mighty long way. When I did not know who I was, when I walked in the footsteps of other people, my mother and all the women that were in my lives, you know, they were all being abused. And so abuse became normal to me. Abuse became, that's what I thought love was. Until one day I said, I gotta take these shoes off. And that was only me finding God. And so through that, I had to allow my mind to be renewed. And all of us, we have to have our mind renewed. So I've overcome. One of my t-shirts is, who am I? And each t-shirt speaks a chapter of my life. Who am I? And then the next one was rebuilding from scratch. Because sometimes we have to rebuild from scratch. And let me tell you something, scratch is good because my grandmother used to bake. And she used to do, and we got some bakers in here. And nothing can touch the scratch. The box can't touch the scratch. So sometimes when you find yourself starting over, you got to realize that starting from scratch is good. Because my grandma's cooking was good from scratch. And from that, out of that t-shirt, a new creation. Because God said when we take off the old, we become new in him. So I became new in him. And then after that, it was move with caution. How many know that sometimes we got to move with caution? Yes. We got to know when to go, when to stay, when to speak, when not to speak, when to leave. We got to know those things. Move with caution, even when it comes to people and friends and places. And even today, mm-hmm. in the world that we live in, we got to know that God is saying go left. Yeah, we got to know that God is saying go right. Yeah. We got to move with caution and making big decisions. And now after that one, it was overcoming her. Because I've overcome a lot of things. I've overcome physical abuse and mental abuse. I've overcome alcohol. I've overcome low self-esteem, insecurities. I've overcome depression. I've overcome suicidal thoughts. But the greatest thing that I had to overcome was me. That was the hardest part. I had to learn how to love April the way God loves April. And I hope this is his character. This is not about me. It's about all of us. I just don't know your mind. I don't know your you know what you've been through and what you're going through. I don't know where you are, but I know we good at dressing it up. You know, I lost my father 2 years ago to COVID, when COVID first came to play. And I thought I'd been through some hard things in life. And when I lost my dad, I almost lost my mind. Because I'm from the Bronx, and he didn't still live in the Bronx, and we couldn't get to him. So my goodbye came through a laptop. That last breath. I know I'm getting healed because I can talk about it without crying. It's been close to 3 years coming up on it. But when I don't know, some of you already may have experienced that, but from my experience, it did something to me when I couldn't get to my dad. When I had to sit there, and I thank God for every nurse and every doctor that took time out to, call us and keep us, updated, because New York, it was horrible. I would see on the news how they were taking bodies out and put them in the tractor-trailer trucks, and they were finding U-Haul trucks with dead bodies, and all I could do was pray from a distance. Let it not be my father. But that phone call came, and I watched my dad take his last breath through the video. Did not get his ashes until months later. So when they came, I had to go all through the grieving process all over again, which the grieving process never stopped. But in that, it did something to me. And it started pulling me into a depression, because if you know my father's story, my father battled with depression. He tried to commit suicide twice. And so for him to die alone, that did something to me. But in that, one day, sitting on my couch, God said, I need to reintroduce myself to you, because you left me at the grave, and I ain't there. So this reintroducing God to me, that's what God wants to do to all of us. All of us who have experienced loss and whatever your situation may be, sometimes you got to allow God to reintroduce himself to you. And you will get to know him in a way that you've never known him. Because had not that happened, I would not know God to be a keeper the way that I do. I would not know to let him know that, God said, I got you. I'm going to keep your mind. And he has. But it's been oppressed. Church hurt is the worst hurt that some of us can go through. But even in that, God allowed me to go through that so I could get to know him in a better way. Because I wasn't born a Christian. I was brought a Muslim. And so I had to find Jesus for myself. You know what I'm saying? And I don't knock nobody's religion. But I had to get to know Jesus for myself. Not because of my mother, not because of my grandparents. I had to find him for myself. So when I found him, I had to hold on to him and deprogram and get to know the truth. And everybody's truth is different, But in that, God has been good. So when I started going to church, I went head first. You can tell I'm saved. What, April? The one that's, this is my hometown. I don't no longer live here. I ran from this place. I ran because I didn't like who I was when I was here. So I had to get away. And so it feels good coming back in my hometown new. new song, a new dance. Reach those young ladies that's out there that may be caught up in what I was. I thank God because it was nobody but him. But I went into church head on, and I'm going to tell y'all, I had the church people up here. And y'all up here. Y'all was some good people. Y'all couldn't do no wrong. Y'all was some good people, and I was happy that I'm finally one of y'all. But my God.
Amen.
I'm going to keep it real. I told God, if you ever use me, I'm going to keep it real.
Amen.
I'm going to keep it real. That thing hurt worse than my ribs being cracked. That thing hurt worse than my nose being broke. That thing hurt more than my lip being busted. That thing hurt. Woo! Honey, let me tell you, if it wasn't for God, I would have walked away.
Amen.
And I did.
I know that's right.
I did, because I didn't understand it.
Yes.
But through it all, by and by, he said, if you just stick with me a little longer, baby girl, I'm going to show you you'll never put another living soul on a pedestal. Not your pastor, not your bishop, not your grandpa, not your pastor. Nobody but me. I said, and I'm the God over your life. Don't you never trust in another soul more than you trust me. That was some pain that I went through. But here I am. And I can tell you this, God pats me on the back because he says, girlfriend, I'm proud of you. Because all what you've been through, you should have walked away from me. But I haven't. And I refuse. I just got a better knowledge of who he is. And where to place people. We gotta set boundaries. And we gotta set them high. And we can't lower them for anybody or anything. Can't nobody go before God. My trust has been broken. And I'm in a good space with the trust.
Yeah.
You know, I'm at a good place with it. But everybody can't get in. You gotta guard your heart these days. And whatever little hope that you're holding on for whatever it is, that's all you need. Is that little bit of hope. You got a little bit of hope for your child getting delivered. Hold on to that little bit of hope. If you got a little bit of hope for your finances to change, hold on to that little bit of hope. If you got a little bit of hope for the sickness that's in your body, hold on to that little bit of hope. If you got a little bit of hope that God is keeping your mind, all you got to do is hold on to that little hope. Because in due season, you shall reap your harvest if you faint not. In due season, your situation will change. In due season. But one thing that I had to learn was that God's ways is really not our ways. And his thoughts are really not our thoughts. And so sometimes we can get tripped up because our prayers don't look like God's answers. But I'm going to close with this. All things work together for the good of them who love. He loves us. And all of us sitting in here today, we got a testimony, and we're holding on. And I pray to God that you never give up. I bless you.
To share with you the reason for the hats in historic black churches. Black women started actually wearing the hats to church. We were allowed to go to church, but they felt like our hair was hideous and it was unsightly. So they made us cover our hair. And thus you see the rags that we wore back in. But as sisters do, we got fancy with it. We got glitter. We got feathers. We got nets. And we went all the way with it. So we still celebrate, but there is a history to that. And the glory to that is we don't have to do that anymore. We can wear a hat. We don't have to wear a hat. We can wear our hair. We can wear somebody else's hair. It doesn't matter.
pour them water. Everybody look at your tickets closely. 741, last three numbers. Jump, go once.
Wait a minute.
Well, somebody like, oh, he's gonna pick another number. No, he won't. 741 are the last three numbers. 741.
I didn't put that.
DJ. All right, DJ.
Yay!
Let's see. 741. 741, we got a winner.
Does it match?
You want to go next?
All righty, we're moving on to our next bag.
Yeah.
Thank you.
and they will do their last for their applause. Ladies and gentlemen, Kathleen Arthur, MC Track Designs, Trace Academy's director. Okay, so now, can I get some volunteers that would like to come and get a training on how to model walk? Come on, ladies, don't be shy. We want to do a whole, we want to model these hats off and get a nice video. Come on, ladies. Everybody, as we come to the floor.
To another pose. 1, 2, 3. You do a full turn. Look back. Walk with the same foot. I'm just doing the basic with y'all. Y'all come here. You do another turn. You do your pose. And you walk off. That's it. So I'm going to have you do it again for you guys, just the basic, so you'll know once you get started.
Martina.
Walk
there,
walk.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
That was Adina. This is Gianna.
And Gianna.
There
you go.
Okay.
These are runway slayers, we call it. And this is Adina. They're all our ambassadors for MC Trek Designs, so they're brand ambassadors. Yes. And so let's get two people up here. First two. Oh, now you came ran to me and said you want a mile. And you run behind your mom. Okay. Kathy, you want to walk in between them?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then that will, so we can see. Thank you. Hey, so what you think? You ready to put this together on a show? Okay. Ready? You ready? All right, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Sunday's Best Hat Show.
Remember stance?
All right. energy in there, baby. Get that energy going. Get that energy going. There you go. All right. Yes, yes. Poses. Ready? There you go. Nice. Love it. You all are too much.
Here we go.
go. All right. Last three numbers is 659. 659. Last three numbers on the tickets. Oh. Let's see the proof. 659. 659, we got a winner. All right, we're moving on, We got another bag. Got another, another bag. All right. Mix them up a little bit. Last three numbers are 578. Last three numbers, five. We in here. We in there. Yeah. 578, we in there. Give it up for another purse, another pocketbook. All right, let's get the. Okay, let's see. All right, last three numbers is 560. 560, last three numbers. Ooh, drop the ticket. 560, we got a winner. You wanna go home and eat? I'm sorry, y'all.
So we did have some fun today, right?
Yeah. Right? Like, give it up if you had fun tonight. I don't know what y'all, but I had some fun. That was fun. All right, last three numbers are 551. 551, everybody, check your tickets for 551. We got a winner with a 551. You all are people like, all right, I see you. Let's see. Somebody gonna go home smelling good. Let me see. Last three numbers are 759. 759. Last three numbers are 75.
Oh, good. No.
Yeah, we got a million of them over here. Still going too. 759. We got a winner. Philosophy, amazing grace. All right, last three numbers are 762. 762.
That's probably me too.
She
called
me black.
Yeah,
she
gets a black. That's right,
for a
park. I have a
and I'm not a
pet
one.
Yeah.
I'm going to ask Ms. Don Pearson, our Cumberland County Commissioner, to give us some closing remarks for tonight. She doesn't have to say anything other than she do whatever she wants to say.
I was bum rushed by people. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
This was absolutely amazing. It was much needed.
Yes.
Very necessary.
Thank you.
And it's not a funeral.
Yes,
this was a joyous occasion.
Yes,
and I came.
Amen. So
thank you. And I hope everybody enjoyed themselves as much as I did.
Good.
Thank you, my dear. I want her call crying so bad.
You got the dog.
Okay, look.